I've tried to get him to have conversations like that.
Right.
But then he kind of like panics.
Exactly. And that's why I think that, see, when you're describing him and I hear the guy, you know, I'm not trying to let him off the hook here. I'm just trying to tell you what I think is the possible cause of it. This is a guy that's out of control of himself and feels controlled by kind of whoever is pulling at him. This project, this job, this schedule, this wife, this whatever it is on the outside. And so the reason I think that he feels panicked in dealing with you is that he just perceives anything from the outside as getting control of him. So he avoids you like, you know, passive men do. And there's kind of, you know, the answer that's for divorce for him. And what I think you need to do is not have this conversation. It's just that if the hell came around, he can be sort of a landing pad for each of your desires and what you're doing, which is your hurt. And from the pattern of that, I think for your parents. And if you want to know, the two of you guys, you know, if you can get to what you want, then you can look at what each person has got to contribute in order for that to happen, and then you get a clear answer of whether everybody's willing to do that, and then you have somewhere to go. So right now you guys are just trading, you know, volleys on a tennis court of arguments.
Yeah, I'm looking at... I really would like you to change your perception of him, to have a real strong investment in what he wants. He's in there for a reason. He's in that marriage for a reason.
I know that he loves me. I know that he cares about me. I just don't know. I don't know. Like, I think the word that you said, control, is like a really big thing with him. His mother's dead now, but his dad is so controlling.
Right. That's my whole point. And it's really sad how many marriages go into with so much loving people because the feeling of self-awareness with them.
I'll show you boundaries in marriage. I hope that will be a couple. John, I think you called her Misty. Well, I don't know. Her name is Dawn. Maybe this is Misty and it's Dawn often.
Maybe that was your father. You know how to have
these
things.
I'm trying to go with some kind of metaphors. If you need some help, boundaries in marriage is available to you. You know, we are a nice people.
It's exactly the same. Who are you? Haiku. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Praise God. You're listening to KUAU. Haiku, Maui, 1570 AM. How do you do? What would you do if society around you was in a building?
Sunday morning, 8 AM, here on KUAU, 1570 AM.
It happens increasingly in this fallen world. It happened in Albania in 1997. But the man in this story is prepared for the chaos because his heart is bound and gone. So come to us.
But all my life I've heard from the communists that they're using the opiate of the people. It's hard to believe they're really bad.
I believe that they're not the same as freedom.
Thank you.
most of the places we can.
Now the Bible tells us that we can go between the night and the morning.